Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. This time I will show you how to map a Java enum to a database column. JPA and Hibernate provide two standard options to map an enum to a database column. You can either use its string representation or its ordinal value. Both approaches have their drawbacks. The string representation is verbose, and the renaming of an enum value requires you to also update your database. The ordinal of an enum value is its position in the enum declaration. This value changes, which requires you to update your database, when you remove an existing value or don't add new values to the end of the enum declaration. You can define a custom mapping and avoid these issues with an attribute converter. When you use JPA's and Hibernate standard mapping, you can either rely on the default mapping using the ordinal or specify the mapping approach. You can do that with an enumerated annotation, which you can see here on the slide. If you don't provide an enumerated annotation or don't set an enum type as its value, the ordinal of the enum value gets mapped to the database. Here you can see the author status enum with its values published, self-published, and not published. And this is the same entity as I showed you on the slide. The enumerated annotation tells Hibernate to use the ordinal value to persist the status attribute. When I now persist a new author entity with the author status published, Hibernate will write the value 0 to the database. Okay, the test case was successful. Let's take a quick look at the database before we talk about the enum type string. Here you can see the record which we created with the test case. As expected, Hibernate stored the value 0 as the ordinal representation of the author status value published. If you want to map the string representation to the database, you need to annotate the entity attribute with enumerated and set the enum type string as its value. This is the same project as in the previous example. I just changed the enum type to string. When I now run the same test case, Hibernate will persist the string published in the database. And here you can see the database table. The status column is now of type character varying, and Hibernate persisted the string published. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about Java 8 support in Hibernate, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.